Hello everyone, welcome back. Last week I was talking about Transit by Rachel Cusk, a book that I absolutely loved. I was really pleased as well to see lots of people in the comments who had read Outline, the previous book, and I'd love that as much as I did. She is a Marmite writer, so she's not going to be to everybody's tastes, but those who do love her have got a proper treat in store with Transit, and indeed with Outline before it and the book that will come after it, which I will say more at some point. I had two copies to give away, and the lucky people winning those are Jane Catherine on books, to give her her full name, and Philip Simons. So congratulations, both of you. You will find my email address at the bottom of this video's description. Send me your postal addresses, and I will get copies off to you as soon as I can. This week, the Hogarth Shakespeare Project returns, and I'm here to talk about Margaret Atwood's novel Hag-Seed, which is her take on The Tempest. Quickly, for those who don't know, the Hogarth Shakespeare Project is the sort of uniting of some of our best-loved authors with the plays of Shakespeare, and they create a new novel based on one of those plays. So Jeanette Winterson kicked things off with her take on The Winter's Tale, which is called The Gap of Time. Howard Jacobson did his take on The Merchant of Venice, which is called Sherlock is My Name. And then we had Anne Tyler's take on The Taming of the Shrew, which is called Vinegar Girl. And any videos that I've made about those books will be linked up above, down below, all over the place. It's a really, really interesting series, and it's really interesting to see how the different authors approach the plays differently and decide whether they're going to sort of take the plot or the themes or something about the plays, and how wildly they sort of move away from the source material. A lot of people, I think, like me, when they heard that Margaret Atwood was going to be taking The Tempest, just kind of did a little dance of joy, because it just seems like the perfect marriage of author and play. And in fact, actually, I think that's been the case for the whole series. It's all about finding the right person to tackle the right play. But I think because Margaret Atwood has made such a name for writing these dystopian futures and being a really creative writer, The Tempest, with all of its magic, seemed to be the right kind of play for her. But sort of contrary to what you might have expected, this is not a play, or rather, this is not a novel set in any kind of dystopian future. It is very much set in the real world in which we all live. This is the book here, another amazing cover. It's got these, again, these lovely Shakespearean end papers. Always a beautiful production, these hardbacks. It's got a lovely, lovely matte cover, which you can probably even hear. Anyway, this is Hag-Seed. Hag-Seed, if you're a Shakespearean buff, you will know is the word, it's how Caliban is referred to. He is the seed of the hag, Sycorax, his mother. And where to begin with this book? As I said, it's set very much in the real, and what we are following is a theatre director called Felix, who used to run a theatre festival and had been sort of, you know, the lord and commander of that whole thing. But unbeknownst to him, his business partner had been very slowly sort of in the background taking control of things and ended up getting rid of him, getting him fired. He takes over the festival, and Felix sort of imposes a sort of exile on himself. He just takes himself away to live in the middle of nowhere in this barn, and begins to sort of foment his revenge. How is he going to get his own back on this so-called friend of his? And what we're also dealing with here is a man who has lost not just his wife, but also his daughter. And Miranda is like a sort of is a presence in his life. He is. It's almost like he's talking to her, if you see what I mean, throughout the novel. And so, in many ways, this is a novel about grief and about loss and how to deal with it. It is also very much a novel about revenge as well. So it has this fantastic plot, great use of the Shakespearean plot, and here Felix has an opportunity when working within a prison to put on a production of The Tempest to effect his revenge. And I won't give away too much of what happens there, except to say that it's rather brilliantly done. And in fact, I don't want to say too much more about the plot of the book, except to say that I think probably more than any other book so far in this series, it really engages with the theatricality of Shakespeare. Because up until now, the novels have not been anything to do with theatre. They have been to do with the plot or the themes of the plays. But this is absolutely about mounting a play. It's about the theatricality. It's about the language. These prisoners, rather hilariously, are not allowed to swear whilst they're doing rehearsals for this play. They're only allowed to swear using Elizabethan swear words, which leads to sort of, you know, you've got these hilarious, not hilarious, these sort of rather big bruiser criminals in prison, but having to use Elizabethan sort of swear words and epithets and stuff, which is just great. And there is this great sort of use of how theatricality works and how production works in order for Felix to effect his revenge. And the other thing I'll say as well, actually, is that it's surprisingly moving. So that, as I said, it's about to, how to deal or how somebody is dealing or not dealing with their grief. And that the resolution of the book is incredibly affecting, I thought. And because it's been such an entertainment up until that point, I was surprised at how, you know, it's sort of tear-jerking towards the end. And it's a really sensitive way of dealing with something that's been running throughout the book. And you realise that as much as this is a book about revenge, it is also a book about resolution and moving on and accepting grief, which is a very clever thing to have achieved, I think, within the same book. I mean, you know, Margaret Atwood's a genius. We know this. So, yeah, it's a fabulous addition to this series. She came into the office just yesterday. So you can't have this copy because this is my copy that she signed, which is very exciting. But I have two copies to give away. So if you are interested, please leave a comment below. Make sure you're subscribed and I'll pick two winners next week. I can't remember what I'm talking about next week. You'll just have to tune in to see. But that is all for this week. Take care.